5G.
It's called 5G.
What comes to your mind first when you think about 5G? Does it scare you? Or make you happy thinking about it? Why is 5G generating so much friction when it is not even operational yet? First, let's explore what actually 5G is. First generation, 1G, which enabled us to make voice calls to each other. Second generation, 2G. Second generation accused us of sending and receiving text messages. Third generation, 3G, from which you can send and receive data. Fourth generation, 4G, it enabled us to download videos faster and play video games. Fifth generation, 5G. 5G will increase the speed of data transmission. We will be able to download these videos in a few seconds, or half of a second. This is because 5G uses higher frequency waves than 3G and 4G. It can provide fastest internet speed to many devices at the same time. But the question is, whether the 5G is safe for humans and the surrounding environment? The frequency of 5G signals is about 30 to 300 GHz, which can cause many issues. But different wireless companies and even government agencies such as the Centers for Disease Control and Prevention and United States Environmental Protection Agency believe that 5G networks used microwave and millimeter wavelength radiations, which are considered non-ionizing and don't produce any kind of energy that directly damages cells. Ionizing radiation is energy that is released and damages cells and causes cancer. Although this radiation is non-ionizing, but it can damage cells through oxidative stress, which can lead to cancer and other disease. So, what is the outcome of all this? Who is right and who is wrong? It's complicated. But before using it, it is important to know its advantages and disadvantages. For the time being, 5G seems safe. But there is simply not enough data to know for sure.